Very good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon, sir.
How are you all?
Fine.
Great. Today's session is going to be something on a very common topic, a very common and a very tasty topic, we can say. That is going to be on sauces. Okay? We are going to do a session on sauces.
Yes.
Getting it? Now, when we talk about sauce, what's the first thing that comes in your mind?
Tomato sauce.
Cheese
sauce.
Soya sauce.
Soya sauce.
Wow.
Sweet chili sauce.
A lot of sauces. Our food has some of the other ingredients that we generally, even chutneys, for example, if we take, they are also sauces. Okay, something that increases the palate of our food, something that makes your food more palatable, that makes you makes your food more moisty, it makes your more food taste more tasty. Getting it? So sauces play a very important role in our day-to-day food life. You understand? So that we are going to learn today. Okay. One more thing, we are all our first years, right?
Yes.
And continental food, when we talk something about continental food, it has to come with a lot of sauces along. It has to come with a lot of sauces, getting it? Like for example, we have we have six other sauces, and along with it, we have a lot of derivatives coming, getting it? So, when we talk about, yes?
So why we call it mother sauce?
Okay, a very nice question, I must say, Aishwarya. Okay, so why do we call it mother sauces? The very important thing here, because mother, basically in our family also, we consider a genuine person, like our mother is generally a genuine person, we can say, getting it? Obviously, father is exactly, but then a genuine recipe or a traditional recipe is considered as the mother sauce, you understand? Like mayonnaise, a pure mayonnaise is only considered as a mother sauce, you understand? We can't add anything else than the traditional recipe in the sauce, and we can't call it mayonnaise sauce, you understand? If we add something else to the mayonnaise sauce, like you can add some tomato ketchup, it becomes a Thousand Island sauce, but we can't call it a mayonnaise sauce, you understand? So when we make mayonnaise sauce, it has to be a traditional recipe, and there are total six mother sauce.
Six mother sauce,
you understand? They have a very traditional recipe, okay, which has been developed during the time of Chef August Escoffier. Okay, a very great chef of that time, who has written a first recipe and a culinary book called as Marc Cuisine. It's which book?
Marc
Cuisine. That is My Cuisine. In French language, it's called as a My Cuisine. Okay, I'm very happy that your people are understanding Suvai's work.
Yes,
so great. So when we basically do, I'm going to today show you a demo. I have got all the ingredients made. Got together just for making mayonnaise sauce. Getting it?
Yes,
I'm going to show you today mayonnaise sauce. How do we make a mayonnaise sauce? Okay. And okay, when I talk something about a mayonnaise sauce, this sauce is basically called as
cold.
Which sauce?
Cold sauce.
Cold sauce. Very true. It's a cold sauce because you have it with burgers. Yes or not?
Yes.
And it is one more thing that has to be considered here is it is a emulsified sauce. Okay. What is emulsified exactly? Emulsified is basically when two different liquids to mix together. Okay, like two different liquids which are not supposed to mix together. When we do it with some adding some force, this thing is called as emulsification. That is two liquids which are being mixed forcibly is called as emulsification. So here in mayonnaise we are going to mix two liquids forcibly. That is your yolk, which has also some water content in it, and some oil. It also has some fat content in it. So basically, oil is a liquid, and it also has some water, that is also liquid. And we are going to forcefully amalgamate it together. Yes, Vivek?
So why we use only egg yolk? Why not
Exactly, egg yolk. Because mayonnaise in itself has a body. It has a
body.
It is thick in nature, you understand? And that is why. Egg white, if you see, what it has? It has only water plus proteins. Nothing else than that. So water is, even if you add oil to it, okay, it has water plus proteins. That is pure water. Do you think so oil will mix with water? No matter how hard you mix it, no, obviously not. Because why? Because water is heavier than oil. You understand?
Yes.
So basically we are going to use egg yolk here. Because egg yolk is, first of all, has a lot of fats in it, okay, which is suitable for the temperature in outside country, okay, like foreign countries. And plus, egg yolk gives a body to the mayonnaise. It gives a
body,
a taste, a texture to the mayonnaise. Getting it? I hope you are aware about
yes,
that.
Sir.
Okay.
Yes.
So can we start with the making of the mayonnaise process?
Yes.
And
yes,
if any doubts at all, you can ask me while I'm making the mayonnaise. Take it.
Yes,
okay.
Yes,
so first of all, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take an egg and I'm going to remove an egg yolk out of it. What I'm going to remove?
Egg yolk.
Egg yolk out of it. Okay guys, now I'm starting with making of the mayonnaise, okay? So I'll remove the egg out here, everybody can see?
Yes, sir.
Here is the egg white on the side, that is we very famously called as albumen. Okay, we call it as albumen, and here is the egg yolk that we are going to use for making of mayonnaise. Very important thing to be considered here, is that how much oil to be added for one egg yolk.
Okay.
You must have heard about mayonnaise being very fatty. Yes or not? Mayonnaise is very fatty. Okay, any questions, Supradeep?
So is there any ratio of adding oil?
Yes, obviously. That's what I was sharing out with you. I'm very happy that you're asking a lot of questions. But it's basically the ratio of it is one egg yolk, okay, yes, with 110 ml of oil. It's one egg yolk with 110 ml of salad oil. It is salad oil, okay? It's not the normal oil what we are going to use here, okay? It's a salad oil. Why salad oil? Because like if we are making mayonnaise for some dressing of the salads, okay, yes, people expect it to be a bit healthy. They don't need a lot of oil. You understand? Vegetable oil is people consider it as unhealthy oil because more content, more fat content of oil is there in normal oils. Getting it? So we are generally going to use the oil which is called as salad oil. Getting it? So here I have my salad oil also. Okay. So what I'm going to do is with my hand, I'm going to separate the egg yolk with the egg white. Getting it? So here I add egg yolk, okay? Added egg yolk here. A pinch of salt, you just have to add a pinch of salt, okay? White pepper, pinch of. Now why white pepper is just for taste. Salt, just for taste. Even the mustard piece, if you consider, it is also we are going to add it for just taste, okay?
Sir,
so you, yes?
What is the role of mustard paste?
Again, taste. Okay. Mayonnaise has to be very tasty. That's the main, because we all love burgers, right?
Yes.
I hope you all love burgers,
yeah,
right? So that's the same reason why we adding mayonnaise, adding mustard in the mayonnaise, basically.
Sir,
yes,
we can even use black pepper, right? Instead of white pepper.
Now, why not black pepper? Very good question, I must say, because, like I said you, mayonnaise has its own traditional recipe. Getting it? If you put black pepper into it, what will happen? Mayonnaise what in color? It's white in color.
White.
If we add some black pepper to it, what is going to happen? It will make it black.
Nice.
And we don't want the mayonnaise to look black. You understand? We want it to look nice and white. Okay? White or a bit of yellowish towards white. Getting it? Now what I want to do is, I've added this, now I'm going to add some vinegar. Vinegar is generally added 1 tablespoon, not more than that. Okay, so I'm going to add some 1 tablespoon.
So instead of this, why we can't use lemon juice? In this,
I didn't get your question, please.
Like you have put vinegar.
Yes.
So then why we can't use in this lemon juice?
Why can't? You should add some acidic content to it. Some acidic content that turns the mayonnaise very, it makes your mayonnaise whitish in color and gives a very tangy flavor to it. Okay. So and it helps in the emulsifying part of the mayonnaise. Getting it? So now added all the ingredients to it. Now I'm going to start whisking it. Can I have somebody of you to help me,
yes,
with the oil? Very slowly and steadily, I am going to add oil to it, not now. Here, I am going to wait for the bubbles to come through this mixture. I am going to wait for this mixture to get some bubbles and then I am going to add oil to it. Ready? Now, very slowly and steadily, what I am going to do is, with the help of Ankush, I am going to add some very drippings of oil to it. Now, this oil has been measured, it's 110 ml of oil. Slowly, very slowly.
Sir.
Okay, why oil slowly? Getting it? So I'll tell you. Now we are trying to forcefully add the liquids together. What are we going to do? We are forcefully adding the liquids together. Getting it? So very slow by slow is the best procedure to follow. If we add it once in a time, it will not get mixed properly. You understand? That is the reason why we are adding this oil at a very slow pace. One more thing, you have to continuously whisk while making a mayonnaise. You can't make a good mayonnaise unless you are not whisking it very properly. Okay?
Sir, we can even use egg beater, right? Instead of this.
No, we can't use egg beater. Because the reason we can't use egg beater here is, what will happen if the egg beater is used? What will happen? The egg will
getting it? We don't want the egg to pop up. We want it to be a smooth mixture. Getting it?
Okay, we have got the mayonnaise, okay?
Sir, you are whisking from 10 minutes, so how much time it take?
See, I'll tell you, here I am doing it manually. So manually when I do some things, it is going to take time. But in industry, does not happen the same way. Industry, what we use is, we have a bakery, we have industrial whisk out and bakery. What we do is, in our whisking machine, we just add our yolks, we add vinegar, we add salt, pepper, mustard, and then we just keep it on electronic whisking. After some point of time, we start putting oil, salad oil to it, and we get the ready-made mayonnaise made. You understand?
Yes.
So that's much, much more easy in industry than here. But here we are not making quantities. Just for the, just for it, we are making for just 2-3 people. For that, I am using here my whisk. Getting it? So here we are done with the mayonnaise. You all can see the texture of the mayonnaise here.
Yes.
You, can you feel any oil here? Can you feel any oil in this? No. It's smooth and nice. Okay. We can use it as in the dressing as well. Okay, now I'm going to remove the mayonnaise in the bowl. Check it out.
So it's very good, but I want to make it in home. But I wanted to know what is the storing criteria for this. How many days it will last?
See, I think the storage criteria is very good. I can say it can last up to 2 to 3 weeks just because it has oil in it. So like even if we have pickle it out, that is also very oily, you understand? So oily things generally do not tend to get spoiled unless and you don't keep it in refrigerator. So if you can keep it in refrigerator, it can easily stay up to 3 weeks in your house. Okay, so I would love if you all people make mayonnaise at your place,
yes,
and
so
to your moment.
Yes, sir.
Thank you so much. Nice session with all people. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.